Acura has updated its compact RDX SUV for 2022, which is a good thing, because it and the larger MDX SUV contribute about two-thirds of Acura's overall sales in the United States. And the two often trade spots as to which is the best seller in any given month, so it's imperative that they get this right. It's also imperative that Acura gets this right, because the compact luxury SUV segment has never been more hotly contested between the automakers and more desired by consumers like you. So should you buy the new Acura RDX? Well, today we're gonna find out. When this generation of RDX debuted back in 2019, I recall reviewing one of those vehicles and thinking to myself, wow, this is actually a pretty attractive looking offering in this segment. And this 2022 refresh certainly helps the cause even further. That refresh bundles in things like a revised front end design, though our specific tester benefits from the optional A-Spec appearance package, which swaps out the normally chrome trim for this cool blacked out effect, which contrasts quite nicely against this gorgeous Apex blue pearl paint job. Beyond that, some staple Acura features remain, like these cool jewel eye LED headlights, which certainly do look upscale. While things like 18-inch wheels are standard on RDX, again, the A-Spec appearance package comes to the rescue with these cool-looking gray metallic 20-inch wheels, which again have that great contrast effect against the body color, as does the inclusion of more blacked-out trim here in the door. There are some cool, sporty elements at the rear of RDX as well, like these boomerang LED taillights. But if you come down here, some of my favorite features, like this integrated diffuser element, which is certainly very, very cool. But I actually quite like these fat exhaust tips, which have so much personality on an otherwise normal family SUV. The RDX's powertrain carries on largely unchanged. That means under the hood, we have the venerable K20C engine. That's a 2-liter turbo four cylinder, good for 272 horsepower and 280 pound-feet of torque. Power sent to all four wheels in this case via a 10-speed automatic transmission. Front wheel drive is standard on RDX, though our tester benefits from the $2,200 upgrade to all wheel drive. And in this case, this thing returns EPA fuel economy ratings of 21 mpg city, 26 mpg on the freeway, and 23 mpg combined. It's fun hopping back into the RDX again a few years down the road and seeing what Acura has done right and what they've done wrong. I think overall this interior looks and feels very appropriate for its $41,000 base price, though the asterisk there is that of course our well-contented tester rings in at 52 grand. Still, I don't feel wanting for anything from this experience. There's a nice blend of colors, textures, and materials happening in here, the thing I always harp on about interiors. Sure, there's a lot of black happening in this interior, but there is nice contrast between things like this injection foam molded dashboard and these ultra suede inserts, which contrast nicely against all this leather here on the center console and on the door cards and of course on these seats. I also like the list of standard equipment that RDX comes with, including wireless Apple CarPlay, wireless Android Auto, heated power front seats, and this large panoramic sunroof. Naturally, in order to showcase what you can get in an RDX, our tester is basically fully loaded with the technology and advanced packages, which means these seats are also now ventilated as well. We also have things like a wireless phone charging pad down here under the console, built-in navigation, and Acura's excellent 16-speaker ELS audio system, along with a 360-degree parking camera system. It's funny that my only gripes with the RDX are the same ones I had a few years ago, and that the interior does feel a bit, well, button heavy. It is a bit too much going on here between the steering wheel controls here down to the left and of course in this center stack. But the real offender, in my opinion, is actually this infotainment display, which sure looks quite nice, but relies on this clumsy trackpad. Lexus tried a similar thing a few years ago and realized it just doesn't work all that well compared to either a touchscreen or a rotary knob or just some other kind of interface. As you can clearly see, at 6'1", I fit very comfortably in the second row of RDX with ample headroom and tons of knee and legroom down here. It also helps that our fully loaded tester does have features like heated rear seats and two USB-C chargers down here, along with some air vents to improve rear seat circulation. Out back here on the RDX, we of course have a power liftgate, which is height adjustable. Quite nice for me because at 6'1", you can raise this thing nice and high if you want to and not knock your head against it. A common problem you do have on smaller SUVs. Looking beyond that, RDX definitely earns major brownie points back here with 30 cubic feet of storage space and actually plenty of additional storage beneath this false floor here. There's also a 12 volt power supply here on the driver's side, and it's worth noting that of course these second row seats do fold down flat at the pull of a lever. The RDX has always been an interesting proposition from Acura since its debut over a decade ago. For the most part, it's almost always featured a bespoke turbocharged engine calibration, which on its debut was a very uncommon thing, though of course now turbocharged four-cylinder engines have become the norm in this segment. But with that time and experience comes expertise in the subject matter, and so it's unsurprising that this powertrain is a good one. While this 10-speed automatic isn't my favorite, I think, for example, BMW's 8-speed is a better alternative, this turbocharged engine is a real wonder. The RDX is amply torquey off the line and around town, but does reward drivers who do occasionally want to ring it out on a winding road like this. And I bring that up because Acura has always positioned the RDX as being something of a sporty option in the compact SUV segment. That explains why the ride quality has been tuned slightly more on the sporty side of things compared to what you'd find from alternatives like Lexus, for example. Also helping things out in the dynamics department is the fact that our highly equipped advanced trim RDX features adaptive dampers, which means if you toggle the drive mode selector down here, the response of the car changes notably between comfort, normal, and sport. Acura has recently revived its Type S branding. Those are sort of the sportiest trim level versions of a given model that you can get from the brand. They've done that with vehicles like TLX and the larger MDX SUV. And with RDX inherently being just a bit more on the sporty side from the get-go, I do wonder what a potential RDX Type S would be like, because I think it would be quite a lot of fun, and it would be a great alternative to vehicles like, say, the BMW X3 M40i. From behind the wheel, there is very little to complain about with the RDX. Its $41,000 base price is pretty agreeable for a luxury SUV, and even our well-equipped tester rings in at $52,000, and this experience overall feels, well, appropriate for that price point. But as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, the competition is so fierce in the compact luxury SUV segment that it's really going to boil down to what you as the consumer want out of this experience. If sportiness is the name of your game, as you can tell, the RDX is a solid contender. It also helps that it rings in at thousands of dollars less than a comparable BMW X3. And it's a similar story with more luxurious alternatives like the Mercedes-Benz GLC. The Acura is just a much stronger value proposition compared to its European rivals. But when talking about luxury, I would be remiss if I didn't mention the excellent Genesis GV70, because Genesis is a brand that is really positioning themselves as being the ultimate purveyor of luxury at this price point. Their overall fit, finish, and interior feel is just nicer than this. One last choice I want to throw out there for the more budget-conscious buyer out there is the new Mazda CX-50. Even fully loaded, it rings in at just over the base price of this RDX, and it comes very, very nicely equipped and offers an even more punchy turbocharged engine. Mazda has made great strides recently in making their SUVs feel like proper luxury experiences and true alternatives to conventional luxury rivals like Acura or Lexus. Still, from where I'm sitting, the RDX does very little wrong. It can do the sporty thing if you want that, and because it's well equipped at this price point, it does feel amply luxurious as you would expect from the brand. All of this does in fact make it a solid contender in the luxury compact SUV segment. Though, I implore you, if you want to learn more about the new RDX and some of the other vehicles I've mentioned throughout this review, you can do so by clicking the link in the description down below.